to Ururoa Flavel.
Tēnā koe, Mr. Speaker, kia ora tātou katoa, e hoa mākai roto I te whare tēnei ahi ahi. Mr. Speaker, the Māori Party, we entered into an arrangement with the governing party, as you'll be aware of, to basically be at the decision-making table, to do all that we could to make a difference in the lives of tangata whenua o Aotearoa. As provided in the treaty, tangata whenua should have an equitable say in the decisions that affect them. Sir, a key principle for us is the need to have a place, to have in place robust and accountable work practices by local government and regional authorities when working with mana whenua. We want to ensure that local governments acknowledge the mana and the authority of mana whenua, engage with Māori communities, build relationships and advance Māori representation. And so, when we come to this particular bill, the Regulatory Reform Bill, in the broadest sense, we support the approach of reviewing existing regulations to remove requirements that may be unnecessary, ineffective, or excessively costly for business. Mr. Speaker, this bill, in its most basic form, is about amending 13X, as other members of the House have spoken about this afternoon, basically to make small gains to improve the quality of the regulatory environment. As a principle, we welcome the context of reducing an overly heavy compliance burden upon businesses, though we would want to ensure that the disaster of leaky homes is not repeated because of reduced regulations. So I say all of this from the perspective, a particular perspective of Māori entrepreneurs. It's well known that if the Māori nation was assessed as a country, Aotearoa would have ranked as the seventh most entrepreneurial nation in the world. In fact, if we were to look at the age group between 35 and 44 years of age, it could be said that one third of an entire generation of Māori start their own business. And for those in the senior stakes, apparently Māori aged between 55 and 64 are some of the most entrepreneurial elders across the globe. The rate of early age entrepreneurship amongst this group is about double the average. But somehow, between the sort of startup and the survival, something goes wrong, sir. We call this the liability of newness to describe the low chance of survival so many Māori entrepreneurs experience. Businesses are said to have survived the liability of newness when they persist in owning and managing an established business for more than 3.5 years. While 1 in 4 Māori expect to launch a startup venture in the next 3 years, only 6.5% of Māori entrepreneurs are in the category of owning and managing a company that has paid wages or salaries for more than 3.5 years. And so we come back to this Regulatory Reform Bill thinking about this major issue for Māori businesses, the sink or swim survival strategy that comes with starting up a new business. Mr. Speaker, this bill seeks to amend a range of small regulatory fixes that makes life easier. It clarifies the Unit Trust Act, for example, so that financial statements and accounts can be distributed electronically. It amends the Agricultural Compounds and Veterinary Medicines Act to remove the requirement for the details of product manufacturers to be included on the public register. And it will impact on the Companies Act 1993 to allow companies to choose whether or not to use electronic shareholder participation. There's a whole lot of other amendments that are in a similar vein, but I won't touch on those too much because some of them have been spoken about already. So all of these things, they're hardly breaking news sort of stuff, but we would hope that all of these changes are not merely cosmetic, but actually help to increase productivity for Māori businesses and allow them to focus on their business rather than fussing around over the compliance costs. So we will be supporting this bill at the first reading. Kia ora tātou.